Hey friends, today we're looking at Signals, a radical change coming to Angular, which is a framework better known for, well, not making radical changes. Does this change signal a resurgence of the TypeScript-based framework? What is the new reactive primitive being introduced? Will this change how Angular is perceived? We'll look at all this and more. In particular, we'll be exploring the following. First, how zone.js-based change detection works in Angular, and how the new signals reactive primitive will work, and what the impact of this change will bring. Because let's face it, Angular is just not fashionable. But being fashionable was never its goal. Angular's goal is to be solid, reliable, safe. It provides structure and it's opinionated. It targets the use cases where reliability is the first requirement. The consequences of that mindset are twofold. First, Angular doesn't naturally fit with environments where agility is the first requirement, such as startups. Secondly, Angular itself is slow to adapt new paradigms. However, the Angular team has recently signaled that it's preparing to implement a radical change in the framework. This being Angular, everything will be done in a safe and a non-disruptive way. And in a sense, by not jumping on every single JavaScript bandwagon, the Angular team has been able to be selective. They've decided to go ahead with a concept inspired by a recent framework. And I wonder to what extent the Angular team was inspired by the name of that framework and how it dovetails with their core values. To be able to understand what that change is, first, let's look at how change detection works in Angular. Angular uses a library called zone.js. This library mainly does two things. First, it monkey patches the browser APIs that hijack all the asynchronous events. Basically, it intercepts click events, timeouts, API calls, and the like. Second, it wraps these events and the code calling them into a JavaScript object called a zone that preserves the invocation context. Angular uses this library to wrap its component parts and to trigger updates whenever an external event occurs. This library was groundbreaking when it was introduced in 2014. To be fair, back then JavaScript was missing many of the features it has now, such as promises and the fat arrow syntax, which help preserve context. The team did what they could with the tools that they had. But given the scale and the ambition of today's applications, this approach is brute force. It lacks granularity. Angular needed a way to do atomic reactivity. It needed a way to be selective in its updates. And this is where signals come in. What are signals? You may have already heard the term. Signals are a concept championed by the Solid framework, which I've explored previously. In Solid.js, signals allow developers to declare fine-grained dependencies between different parts of the application state. Signals track dependencies between components. Whenever the value of a signal is updated, Solid.js automatically triggers a re-rendering of any component that depends on that signal. This makes it easy to create reactive user interfaces that are updated in real time based on changes to the application state. The key feature of signals is that they support fine-grained dependency tracking. This means that Solid.js and later Angular can detect exactly which part of the user interface needs to be updated when the signal changes, and then only re-render those specific parts. This helps improve performance and reduce unnecessary renders. So what will signals change in Angular? In a long discussion on a GitHub post announcing the change, the Angular team has stated that they believe signals will unlock many new capabilities. These include a cleaner model of how data flows through the application, a finer update granularity, making zone.js optional, cleaner and more readable code, and simplifying many framework concepts such as queries and lifecycle hooks. I feel that making signals the default mode of change propagation will help make Angular easy to learn for people familiar with other frameworks. I don't think the change will suddenly make Angular fashionable, but that was never the goal. However, it might help make Angular easy to pick up and write cleaner code in, and that will contribute to making Angular even more solid.